Very good morning to one and all. I am Professor Dr. Abha Singh, MIT Director of Psychology and Dean Humanities Social Sciences. I am expert in the field of psychology. Focus area is positive psychology, counseling, and prevention of mental health issues and problems. So coming to the topic which I want to express my scientific view is positive aging enhances quality of life. Aging is a big burden on our society. I think aging is an asset. As a psychologist, it is my view. But my view is backed by many cases I see, many problems I see of the old age. And then I reflect, I introspect as a psychologist, as a scientist, that there is a way out. This burden can easily be transformed into asset. So old age, when we talk about, we only think, in fact I can raise this to all of you as an audience, then what comes to your mind when I speak the term old age? Obviously many of you will start thinking all negative things, problems, issues, burden, family problem, individual problem, and then societal problem. Maybe some of you may think of positivity, which is where I come from, my school of thought, which I am going to express today. Yes, positive aging is not a term given by me as an expert, but it is given by a term WHO, World Health Organization, in 2015. And positive aging is also be called as healthy aging, aging successfully, aging scientifically. So when we talk about age, actually we forget that age is always a number and it is actually more in mind than in body. That is where the problem comes. When individual starts thinking of age as a body problem rather than mind problem, rather than mental problem. Basically it is mental attitude, mental issues with an individual, within himself or herself. And when you talk about positive aging, you have to first think that how I am going to deal with the issues before it happens. So there is a way out. So when you talk about positive aging, you have to start young. It is a saying that 40 is the age of young, which is an old age, and 50 is the age which is the young for old age. So when you start thinking young and try to prepare yourself in advance that how this aging can be successful and useful for you, your family, your society. Now when you talk of aging, either we feel extreme joy or either we can feel extreme dissatisfaction. So how can we be the other continuum, that is extreme joy? And we all humans has, as an individual I can say, we need to experience joy and happiness. The goal of human life, if you ask anybody and try to question him with many questions, and in the end you will come to that answer that everybody wants to be happy and successful and joyful. So how do we get this insight when we are young, and when you get quality education as well? And through education you get to know many things about your body and mind. That's very important message for everybody, that how in education we are putting this information and scientific information for every individual at very early age to look at. In fact, researches indicate that those children, individual, those who are given this education very early age, they have positive aging rather than aging as a problem or an issue. Further, there was a research in positive psychology stream that those people who think positive, feel positive, they started maintaining their diary very early and used to write positive things, good things about themselves. Every day as a routine, as a gratitude to yourself. And the longitudinal study indicated, after so many years, many of them died, those individuals. But those who lived longer, it was found, they were positive, their thoughts were positive, their emotions were positive. Now here is the question. This research indicated, scientifically proved, that if you are positive in thought, emotion and action, actually you can live positively and happily. For any situation, matter of fact, if it is a big problem or small problem, you can deal with it. You cannot just leave and avoid it. So there are strategies for ourselves, that how we deal with the problems and how we avoid the problems. So when we talk of aging, here you see mostly is avoidance strategy, not a strategy to confront, to deal. So similar example you can see in our society, that today joint family is breaking. Now when joint family is breaking, you see there is a void created between young and old. Now further, if you see the children are going to different country to study, parents are sending them. Then why I always question those parents, then why you have the empty nest syndrome, that nobody is there to take care of me, nobody is there to look after me. You decided, that was your decision to send your children. Now I should be happy as a parent if I am sending my children. So this emptiness syndrome is created in mind first. So how do we get rid of those void, those emptiness, and start living very engaging life and very creative life, positive life? Everybody has certain hobbies, certain passions in their life, certain motivations in their life which they are unable to do when they are doing their regular job. So at some stage, at least you can decide that now I need to take care of myself. You have done everything in your life. I know